The opening day of competition at the Vancouver Games and all eyes on Cypress Mountain for the women's moguls, as the host nation hoped that finally a Canadian would win gold on home soil. It hadn't happened in Montreal or Calgary, but there were high hopes now for Jennifer Heil. In difficult weather conditions, she'd come through the qualifiers with the other favorites, and she couldn't wait to perform in front of the home crowd. The challenge of the moguls to race as fast as possible down a steep slope and perform two very fancy jumps on the way. These were the best of the qualifiers, with four Americans and two Canadians in the top seven, and Jennifer Heil producing a run that was bettered only by Hannah Carney. But the medals would be decided only by the final run. And this was Heather McPhee, lying second in the season's World Cup standings, 1 meter 60 tall, known for her constant efforts to improve by tweaking her technique. McPhee, about to go. The bumpy ride down the moguls course and two jumps to perform. The backflip, but she lost it, and with that, the Olympic dream had vanished. No medal for Heather McPhee, just the commiserations of her American teammate, Shannon Barker, who would remain in provisional first place. McPhee, the former gymnast, who hadn't been able to land the backflip this time, but she was still able to smile. A score, 14.52, 16th place. Next to go, Jennifer Heil, the reigning Olympic champion. A 360 with a good landing. She'd come to the games in sparkling form after winning four consecutive World Cup events. And now here she was, competing at home in the Olympics. She said it was like winning the lottery, but could she win the gold? The Iron Cross backflip, and Jennifer Heil had produced another great run. The 26-year-old Canadian. She'd been a freestyle swimmer for 11 years, but it was freestyle skiing that had brought her the big victories. In 2004, she'd become the first Canadian to win the World Cup Moguls title, a title she took 4 years running. And now, she looked close to making history again. She seemed unaffected by the pressure. As she said, she dealt with plenty of pressure in 2006, and she'd grown up a lot since then. And Jennifer Heil had leapt into first place, but it wasn't as good as her qualification score. It meant the door was open for Hannah Carney, the last to go. The 23-year-old American with two jumps and a whole lot of bumps to conquer, to take the title. The backflip, nicely done. And Carney was traveling over the moguls very, very quickly. The world champion of 2005 as a teenager, now back to her best form in 2010. One more jump to go. The standing 360 twist and a landing that was solid. Hannah Carney across the finish line and into the arms of her teammates. She'd been a little bit faster than Jennifer Heil. The final result all depended on the technical marks. But certainly she'd handled the moguls perfectly, maintaining the snow contact with the skis, and the control on the second jump was exemplary. The verdict of the judges was clear. Carney had won the Olympic title. She'd outscored her rival on the turns, in the air, and in speed. And so, on the podium at Cypress Mountain, 29-year-old Shannon Barker from Squaw Valley in California was the bronze medalist. For the champion in Turin, Jennifer Heil, there was no repeat. Despite skiing phenomenally well in the weeks leading up to the games, she hadn't done quite enough on the big night. It was silver for her, and for the Canadian public, that long wait for gold at home would continue. But for Hannah Carney of the United States, a different story. She'd had a bad time at the Turin Olympics, finishing in 22nd place. But she'd proved her ability not only by winning the World Championship in 2005, She's also taken the World Cup title in 2008. And now, having arrived in Vancouver, ranked world number 3, she would leave as the Olympic number 1. Carney was the champion.